As the presidential debate just wrapped up, candidates touched on some key issues tonight. WNCT's Josh Birch led a roundtable with ECU students representing both parties. And Josh, what did some of those students have to say?
Well, Ken, a lot of what was talked about later on in that debate was about ISIS, national security. Hillary Clinton said that they didn't want to, they wanted to send a strong message to people around the world that the United States was not going to sit by and let state actors try and hack into the United States, and that they would do anything to defend its citizens. Donald Trump said that he wants to knock ISIS out fast, and that if Clinton couldn't do it as Secretary of State, what makes her think that she can do it now as president? And as you mentioned, we are joined here by ECU students. We're going to start with Erin here. She is a supporter of Donald Trump, and he's made some comments that seem to, at least to some people, controversial about allies of America. What do you think about his foreign policy agenda there?
I think Trump actually has a strong foreign policy agenda. I think Americans would like to see him more specific about his agenda, but he did make really strong points about defeating ISIS and being more strong on cybersecurity and things like nuclear disarmament, which is really important. So I think he actually has a strong foreign policy agenda.
And towards the end, the comments that he's made towards women were brought up. You're a woman, obviously. You support Donald Trump. What do you think about those comments?
While I do not agree with the comments he's made, I think you can look at his daughter Ivanka and see that he really does not truly think these things about women. I think he respects women. I don't think that we should be focusing so much on the issue of what he said about women when there are other things that are more important that he has talked about and that we should be focusing on.
Okay, now we're going to switch sides here. We're joined by Haley. She is a Hillary Clinton supporter. And Donald Trump said that she's been in politics for several decades now. Why is she just now talking about these issues and trying to find solutions? What do you think about how she handled that question?
Well, I don't think that question was pretty accurate. I mean, Hillary Clinton has served as Secretary of State. She's served as a senator from New York. She served as First Lady. She's been involved in politics, like he said, for decades, and she has touched on the issues and she's focused on the issues for decades. She's fought for human rights since she was a young woman my age in college. She's fought for children's rights, creating the CHIP program when her husband was president of the United States. And I don't think that she's just now starting to touch on these issues. I think she's touching on them more so because it's an election cycle. But I don't think that question was very accurate in a sense, because she has fought for these rights for several decades.
And real quick, she also touched on the racial issues that's happened in Charlotte and around the country. What do you think briefly of her comments there?
Well, she did say that everyone should respect the law and everyone should be respected by the law, and I respected that statement. I do think that what's happening in Charlotte and what's happening around the United States is a very big movement. And you can see it on ECU campus as well. Many people are touching on the Black Lives Movement. And I just think it's very important that it's being touched on. And I appreciate that she touched on it. And I don't think it should be touched on in a negative light, because they wouldn't be doing it in a negative light if it meant anything. They're trying to bring awareness to what's going on. And I think that's why she focused so much on it.
We appreciate you both being here. And Ken, certainly North Carolina, a battleground state in this election, is probably going to come down to the very end in November. Certainly something that we're going to keep an eye on. We'll send it back to you all.
All right, Josh Birch, live for us in our newsroom tonight.